Today, I'm going to make a very special dish. Guess what? I'm making biryani. So biryani is a very popular dish all over the world. We all know how biryani is made, right? It is a right combination of meat, spices, and the rice. So usually the meat will be cooked in mild spices and later on cooked along with rice. But today, I'm going to make a healthy version of biryani, which is called mandi biryani. Mandi biryani is otherwise called kuri mandi biryani. What mandi means in Arabic is nada, that means a dew-like texture. That means the chicken is cooked under slow cooker for a long time and then later on we add the rice. But in our busy world, we don't have time to slow cook the chicken and the rice and all this thing. So I'm going to make a very easy mandi biryani by adding the spices and putting them in the oven. So let's get started. So for this recipe, we need whole chicken. I usually prefer chicken because I'm not a big fan of red meat. So I take the whole chicken, but you can use any kind of meat, okay? And then the whole chicken, I'm not removing the skin. I will just poke the chicken in few places. I'll show you. And then I'm going to add all the spices. It is better if you can marinate this chicken and keep it overnight. That's the best thing to do. But if you don't have a lot of time, you can keep it for an hour or 2 hours, or maybe less than an hour should be okay. But it's always better to marinate overnight. So I'll show you how we are going to marinate the chicken. Okay, so I got a little helper here. She wants to try everything. No, that's not the way to do it. So I asked her, okay, we'll marinate the spice. I'm not going to let her do it. I'm just going to do the marinate the chicken. So I'm going to take the whole chicken here and she's going to poke the chicken in different places. So Amy is poking the chicken. Usually I use a knife, but I cannot give the knife to Amy, so she's using a fork and she's trying to poke the chicken. So this is the whole chicken I got. So it's a whole chicken and with the skin, because when we put this chicken in the oven, no skin, then the chicken gets dry very fast. So you need the skin to add the masalas or the spices and then you cook in the oven. So here, Amy, you can poke the chicken.
Yeah.
Okay, slowly. Okay. So here I'm using all the spices. So I use 2 teaspoons of chili powder, 2 teaspoons of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of pepper powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 2 teaspoons of salt, because it's a whole chicken. And then finally I'm adding the mandi masala, which is called the Arabic masala. You can use any kind of Arabic masala. It's you know, you get it in the store. And I'm also adding some ginger garlic paste and some little bit of garam masala. This garam masala is homemade. So to make this paste, I will mix all these things together.
Can I?
Okay.
I finished poking.
She finished poking. Slowly, okay? Yeah. So after mixing this, I'm going to add...
It's not ready.
Yeah, it's okay. 2 tablespoons of yogurt. Yogurt makes the chicken very soft. So that's why we usually add yogurt to this. 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste and a little bit of water.
Sure. Oh.
Okay, so you have to slowly mix this. If you want, you can add a little bit of
lemon
juice, like 1/2 teaspoon. Careful, we mixed it up really well. See, look at the texture. So the spice mixture is ready. Into that, I'm adding a little bit of coriander leaves.
And now I'm gonna mix it.
Okay.
But you have
She's
to do
my
it
little
slowly.
Helper.
You have to do it slowly or else it gets
So
everywhere.
The chicken here, I poke the chicken, and you can see I poke the chicken in every places.
most of these places so
and
that the mixture
bit.
Gets into the chicken. I'm going to go very messy here because there's no other way. Okay, just put it on top of the chicken. So Amy is putting the masala on top of... No, don't touch it.
Oh, what are you doing? Your hands...
So I'm putting all the masalas. And Amy is helping me. Okay, wait. That's enough, Amy. Mommy have to take it the other side. Okay, I'm flipping the chicken on the other side. So you have to marinate really well. That's the key. So even if you don't have time to marinate overnight, if you mix the spices to the chicken very well, you just have to keep it outside for an hour, should be good. So this place became a little messy, but it's okay. So you can see all the entire chicken is marinated very well. If you don't want to use your hand, you can use the spoon and marinate, but it's always better to marinate with your hand. So I keep the chicken in the oven 375 degree for say 20 minutes on one side, and then flip it over and keep it for next like 20 more minutes. You can see the skin getting really brown. And if it is getting dried, make sure you put a little bit of that spice on top of it. Brush it with a little bit of spice, or you can just turn it the other side, because that means the side is, that portion is ready. Mandi biryani, we don't need it to be like really crunchy. It has to be soft and succulent. So this is the chicken that came from the oven. So you can see it's not... very dry, it's still juicy, and you can see all these spices outside. So the chicken is ready. Now we'll cook the rice and keep this chicken on the top of this rice. So we'll start cooking the rice. So my mandi biryani is ready. I garnished it with some tomatoes, carrots, and pepper. I hope everybody likes my mandi biryani, and I'm sure you guys will give it a try because it's very simple. All you have to do is buy a whole chicken, put all the spices, and throw it in the oven. It's ready in within 45 minutes. So please. Try this recipe at your home and let me know if you have any questions. Also, whenever you get a chance, please subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye.